Hi, I'm Ashley McGirt, licensed mental health therapist, and here are some tips that you can utilize to help improve your mental health. One thing you can do every single day to make a difference in your mental health is start your day with progressive muscle relaxation. Normally you want to do this in a sitting position, and I always start from the top of my head down to the soles of my feet. So essentially what you want to do is tighten your facial muscles. I know you're going to look really distorted, but it's important to really tighten those facial muscles. And you do that 1 to 3 times, and then you lift up your shoulders, hold it really, really tight, and then release. Tighten, 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 and release. And you want to do at least 3 rounds of each of these so that you're tightening your muscles, releasing the stress that your muscles have held on. We should always speak to ourselves with grace and with kindness. We have to be compassionate and remember that we are humans too. How would you talk to your neighbor? How would you talk to your friend, your child, your partner? That is the same way you should be talking to yourself. A simple exercise that you can utilize in the moment to treat stress, anxiety, even depression is something that's called tapping. It's like acupuncture through the brain. If you YouTube or Google tapping, it's a free tool that you can do quick, easy, and at home. Essentially, you are touching all the acupuncture points and you're tapping through and relieving anxiety. I have a lot of anxiety in my body, but even though I am feeling anxious, I still love and accept myself. So you would start with your hands, the top of your head, down to your face. You can find all the information online. It's free, simple, quick, and easy. Sleep is extremely important. I always say, think of it like your phone. Many of us will not go to sleep without charging our cell phones. We still need to charge our bodies just like we charge our phones. It is the way that our brain charges. It is also how we release stress. It's important to get good, adequate REM sleep as well, because that's how we process some of the things that we experienced throughout the day. Remember to reduce your mental load. If you have this many things on your plate, I say bring it down to here. You can do that by investing into things like paper plates. That way you don't have to wash the dishes every single day, and it's taking one less thing off your to-do list for that week. Self-love is so important, and one way that we love ourselves is through embracing and acknowledging our identity. Research tells us that those who have a solid background and understand where they're from and embrace their identity have better productive lives. One of the biggest things that I would recommend to you is to recognize your signs of stress. I have difficulty concentrating when I'm stressed. So what is it for you? Do you have difficulty sleeping? Are you sleeping too much? Do you stop eating? Know what it looks like when you are stressed. And also have people in your circle who can be your accountability partners who will know. One thing I want you to take away from this is that it is okay to see a therapist. It doesn't mean you're crazy. It doesn't mean that anything is wrong with you. It's actually a preventative step, and I encourage everyone to see a therapist because we all can benefit from mental health services. I'm a therapist, I see a therapist, and I will always, always advocate for therapy as one of the best things that we can do to improve our mental health.